I invite the assembly to rise as you may. So we begin with our call to worship. We stand at the foot of the cross. We weep with the women disciples. The earth shakes, the curtain of the temple is torn asunder. Let us pray. Jesus, our brother and our Savior, on this holy night we gather in fear and sorrow, unable to comprehend the depth of love that would lead you to sacrifice everything for our sake. Strengthen us to remain with you as witnesses to this love. Amen. The assembly may be seated for the word.
A scripture reading from Mark. Then the soldiers led him into the courtyard of the palace, that is the governor's headquarters. And they called together the whole cohort. And they clothed him in a purple cloak. And after twisted some thorns into a crown, they put it on him. And they began to salute him, "Hail, King of the Jews!" They struck his head with a reed, spat upon him, and knelt down in homage to him. After mocking him, they stripped him of the purple cloak and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him out to crucify him.
They compelled a passerby who was coming in from the country to carry his cross. It was Simon of Cyrene, the father of Alexander and Rufus, and they brought Jesus to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of a skull. And they offered him wine mixed with myrrh, but he did not take it. And they crucified him and divided his clothes among them, casting lots to decide what each should take.
Thank you.
Scripture reading from Mark. It was 9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him. The inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." And with him they crucified two bandits, one on his right and one on his left. Those who passed by derided him, shaking their heads and saying, "Aha! You who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself and come down from the cross." In the same way, the chief priests, along with the scribes, were also mocking him among themselves and saying, "He saved others, he cannot save himself. Let the Messiah, the King of Israel, come down from the cross now, so that we may see and believe." Those who were crucified with him also taunted him.
Stand as you may for this last portion of the gospel. When it was noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. At 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out with a loud voice, "Eloi, Eloi, lema sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When some of the bystanders heard it, they said, "Listen, he's calling for Elijah." And someone ran, filled a sponge with sour wine, put it on a stick, and gave it to him to drink, saying, "Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to take him down." Then Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. Now when the centurion who stood facing him saw that in this way he breathed his last, he said, "Truly this man was God's son." Please be seated. If we were living 100 or so years ago, we would have quite a few heavy things to carry around. If you wanted water for cooking or for washing, you carried heavy buckets of water from the well outside into your kitchen. If you wanted to heat your home on a night like tonight, you carried armfuls of firewood that you had chopped down in a nearby tree row and split. If you wanted food to feed your family for the winter, you had to plant, harvest, and then preserve many jars of meat and fruit and vegetables. One by one, those jars you carried were not so heavy, but bringing them back up again from the root cellar again and again became a heavy burden. Today, you don't have to carry those things around. You don't carry heavy buckets of water from your well outside or armfuls of firewood. Instead, you can rely on regular trips to the grocery store for food. You can flip the switch on your furnace and turn on your faucet for water. But you do carry around other heavy things. You carry on your shoulders the unique pressures of your work. You carry the demands of caring for your kids, or for your parents, or maybe even for both. You carry the burden of guilt that you are not doing enough for your job or for your family. Or maybe you're carrying around a grudge, some old heavy hurt you're not quite willing to let go just yet. What we carry around much of the time is really our sin, which is super heavy. We feel guilty when we believe everything and everyone depends on us, as though the world might end if we make a single mistake. Sin is relying on our own abilities and forgetting to rely on Jesus for help. Sin is carrying around an old heavy grudge and refusing to reconcile with that person we've decided has wronged us unforgivably. Sin is that heavy burden we carry around when we do not really want God to be completely in charge of our lives. We carry around our sin. Jesus was forced to carry a crossbar, a heavy piece of wood, on his shoulders. The crossbar was so heavy, in fact, a man named Simon was instructed to help Jesus carry it. This is such a beautiful moment of scripture to me, that even Jesus needed some help carrying heavy things. At the place then called Golgotha, Jesus was nailed to the crossbar and lifted up with it and hung there to be executed. The crossbar was heavy, not only because that log of wood weighed a lot on his shoulders, but also because he carried the heavy burden of our sin along with it. So here's your question. If Jesus carried your sin, then what are you doing still lugging it around? Why do you carry around this fear that the world will fall apart if you make a mistake? Why rely only on yourself when you are merely one human being? And even Jesus needed help carrying heavy things. Why let an old grudge fester when you could feel great relief and peace by letting it go? Earlier on in his life, Jesus said this, "Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest." And from another translation of the Bible called The Message, Jesus said it this way, "Walk with me and work with me, watch how I do it. Learn the unforced rhythms of grace. I won't lay anything heavy or ill-fitting on you. Keep company with me, and you'll learn to live freely and lightly." Later in this service, when we gather here around the cross to sing a hymn called Beneath the Cross of Jesus, lay your burdens down. Leave your sin and your guilt and your grudges. The burdens of this day, as we will sing. Set down your heavy independence, like a heavy bucket of water. You are baptized into the freedom of Christ. That is done. Leave behind your old hurts, the burden of filling up your root cellar or hauling your own firewood. The body of Christ feeds you with grace, and the light of Christ will guide you. Your heavy burdens are the Lord's to carry, if only you will let him. It's as easy as flipping on a light switch or switching on the furnace, making regular trips to the grocery store. Keep company with me, Jesus said, and you will learn to live freely and lightly. Amen.
Let us pray, brothers and sisters, for the Holy Church throughout the world.
Almighty and eternal God, you have shown your glory to all nations in Jesus Christ. By your Holy Spirit, guide the church and gather it throughout the world. Help it to persevere in faith, proclaim your name, and bring the good news of salvation in Christ to all people. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us pray for Bishop Elizabeth Eaton and Bishop Craig Schweitzer, for Pastor Mary Wiggins and Pastor Lisa Luton, for all our seminarians, Ellie Papineau, Cheryl Lance, and Patrick Healy, for all servants of the church, and for all the people of God.
Almighty and eternal God, your Spirit guides the church and makes it holy. Strengthen and uphold our bishops, pastors, other ministers, and lay leaders. Keep them in health and safety for the good of the church. Help each of us in our various vocations to do faithfully the work which you have called us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let us pray for those preparing for baptism.
Almighty and eternal God, you continue to bless the church. Increase the faith and understanding of those preparing for baptism. Give them new birth as your children, and keep them in faith and communion of your holy church. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let us pray for our sisters and brothers who share our faith in Jesus Christ.
Almighty and eternal God, you give your church unity. Look with favor on all who follow Jesus, your Son. Make all the baptized one in the fullness of faith, and keep us united in the fellowship of love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let's pray for the Jewish people, the first to hear the word of God.
Almighty and eternal God, long ago you gave your promise to Abraham and your teaching to Moses. Hear our prayers that the people you called and elected as your own may receive the fulfillment of God's the covenant promises. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Let us pray for those who do not share our faith in Jesus Christ.
Almighty and eternal God, you gather into your embrace all who call out to you under different names. Bring an end to interreligious strife and make us more faithful witnesses of the love made known to us in your Son. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let us pray for those who do not believe in God.
Almighty and eternal God, you created humanity so that all may long to know you and find peace in you. Grant that all may recognize the signs of your love and grace in the world and in the lives of Christians, and gladly acknowledge you as the one true God. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let us pray for God's creation.
Almighty and eternal God, you are the creator of a magnificent universe. Hold all the worlds in the arms of your care and bring all things to fulfillment in you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let us pray for those who serve in public office.
Almighty and eternal God, you are the champion of the poor and the oppressed. In your goodness, give wisdom to those in authority so that all people may enjoy justice, peace, freedom, and a share in the goodness of your creation. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let us pray for those in need.
Almighty and eternal God, you give strength to the weary and new courage to those who've lost heart. Heal the sick, comfort the dying, give safety to travelers, free those unjustly deprived of liberty, and deliver your world from falsehood, hunger, and disease. Hear the prayers of all who call on you in any trouble, that they may have the joy of receiving your help in their need. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Finally, let us pray for all those things of which our Lord would have us ask. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray the prayer that our Lord and Savior has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. I invite the assembly to stand and turn to the back of the sanctuary and face the cross. Behold, the life-giving cross on which was hung the Savior of the whole world. Behold, the life-giving cross on which was hung the Savior of the whole world. Behold, the life-giving cross on which was hung the Savior of the whole world. I invite the assembly to come forward as you may, to come stand here with me around the cross. Note, as we do sing together, it will get dark in the sanctuary, so please do not be startled. And there also, at the conclusion of the service, will be a loud noise, but please come.